Most of the time, people are going to pull their blades on their mower to sharpen them up or just do some regular maintenance on them. But not me. I pull my blades because I hit rocks the size of cantaloupes and bend things all up. You're going to want to remove these guards here so that you can get yourself good access to the spindles, and makes it a little easier to get the blade bolts loosened up. And after those are off, you can raise the deck up. And I like to jack up the mower in the front, from the front of the deck like that. I find that's the easiest way to do it. Not sure if there's any other ways out there. If somebody's got a better method, drop that in the comments. I'd like to check it out. And in lieu of music for this video, I'm just going to let the cicadas play in the background, because those things are loud and hard to fight over with noise. So if you're standing in a tree underneath them and got a decibel meter, they run about 94 decibels on the high end, which is ridiculous. So that's what we're all going to get to listen to. The nuts and bolts for this are 15/16. So you're going to want two of those ready to go when you go to pull these off. This one here is starting to get a little rounded up in the head, so I'm having a hard time keeping a socket and a wrench on it. It's going to be due for replacement soon. Gets a little too round, I'm never getting it off again. Everything with weight is a hammer, so I'm using that wrench as a hammer. Now my jack doesn't lift the deck up as high as I need it to get this first blade off, so that's why I'm putting that jack stand on the far end like that. And this blade here is a little bent, not too bad. So it's got a little bit of a kink in it. I'll straighten that out later, but that's why you should always take a look at where you're mowing before you start mowing if you like your blades. So fresh blade here. By fresh, I mean a used one that I've sharpened. And put that back in, repack everything the way I found it. Slide that up in there and spin that nut down and tighten it up. Then the first blade is done. The rest of them are the same process, just in different locations. So it's not a super challenging process, just a little time consuming because you got to get it up in the air. Now to get to this middle blade, you've got to take your deck locker. I don't know how you'd want to refer to that as, but the item that either locks the deck up or helps you select the position of it for the height that you want, depending on how tall you want to cut your lawn. That pedal that you press on needs to be removed so that you can flip the foot deck up where your feet rest while you're running the mower. So you pull that pin, you slip that up and off, and then you can flip up the center deck that you rest your feet on. That's how you get to the bolts for the center blade. So you've seen this process once before, same as the first one. You loosen up that nut, take that off, and then you're going to drop that bolt down that the blade is sitting on. There are a couple little spacers on the bottom half of the bolt. They're just above the blade, and those help me level the blades out across the deck. They are just a hair rusty and need a small amount of persuasion to be set free. So this is how I went about it, using my wrench as a hammer. And I destroyed that wrench. All of the little pieces fell out of it, and it is now a trash wrench because of that. Should have just went and gotten a hammer. And that's blade number two that I bent the hell out of because I went over a rock instead of checking out what I was doing first. Don't make that mistake like I did, because these blades aren't cheap and it's a bit of work to straighten them out. So these spacers I'm putting on here, those are the ones I was talking about that were rusted on a bit. They just help level the blade out, because that spindle in the middle sits a little higher than the spindle on the end. I don't know if that is unique to this mower or if that's standard for all of these Ferris mowers, but that's why there are spaces on that blade and not the first one. So your need for spacers may vary. And this right here is what I get for using that as a hammer. That is now broke. We're on the last blade here now. It's pretty simple, about the same as the first one, just on the other side of the deck. You don't need to reach all into the middle for it. Just loosen it up, pull that nut off, pull that bolt down that it all sits on, pull your spacers off, and there's your blade, all bent and ready to be replaced. So if you're watching this and enjoying it and getting something useful out of it, I'd ask that you maybe throw a like my way. If you've seen a couple videos now of mine and you're liking them, consider subscribing. I'd greatly appreciate that. Thanks. And since you've gone through the effort to pull these shrouds and you got easy access to it, start greasing the stuff that's underneath that deck. Spindles at bare minimum. Those puppies spin fast and they spin pretty much the whole time the mower's running, so they're getting some wear. So you put a little grease in them, you're gonna get a little more time out of them. They run much better and they're always happier. So take the few minutes, it's worth it. And if you gotta replace one of them, you're gonna wish you'd have greased it a little more often, because they're not horrible to change, but getting those pulleys lined up is a bit of a nuisance, so save yourself the effort. Just grease it. And there we have it. It's time to reassemble. Now that you've got that deck down, you set everything back down on the ground. You're going to want to get your pedal back on there so you can drop that deck back down. For me, the chain that hangs on the left side of that deck, the deck hangs from, that gets caught up from time to time. So I'm going to show you here what it does to me, in case it does it to you. You got an easy way of assessing what it is. See the way that links down on the bottom like that? It needs to be up on the top there. So when you drop that deck down, the deck drops all the way down like that there. I know it's a small thing, simple thing, but maybe it'll help somebody out. I'll leave it in there. This foot pedal is really easy to put back on upside down and wrong. You can't figure out why it doesn't work for a little while, so make sure you pay attention to that when you take it off so you can put it back on properly. I was using a wrench handle to hold that deck up while I had it off. There you go, pull that wrench handle out. Everything's back to normal. The deck does have to be down to get these shrouds back on, so left that locked up unnecessarily. So there we go. Popping these shrouds back on is the last step. After that, we are done. So thank you for checking out this video and hope you have a good one.